A very good afternoon to all our viewers joining to this Dialogue Rugby League last game here from Valley Centre. We are bringing you live on your number one sports hub, www.thepapari.com. Navy is hosting Havelocks. Havelocks on the second of the points table and Navy on the third place of the points table. To talk about today's game, I have joined with Paul Toya and of course Tulagisi Tavita, also no strangers for Sri Lanka rugby as a whole. Paul, talking about today's game, they are playing for pride and Havelocks, they won the first leg in their home ground under lights condition. Navy could have won that game, but it's a different story, especially when you play at Valisera.
That's right, Sabir, and good afternoon, viewers, and good afternoon, Sabir and Lager. So, although both teams are playing for pride here, Navy are playing at their home ground. They want to make sure that they keep this as a fortress, that it's difficult to come here and play. They will have one eye on the knockouts, which are starting next week, but both teams will want to make sure they go into the knockouts with a bit of momentum, make sure that they know how to win. And take that momentum in saying that a couple of players have been rested on either side, so as I said, they are looking towards next week as well, so it'll be interesting. And just looking at the ground as well, Sabir, as we walked across the ground before the game starts, the ground's in superb condition. There's a little bit of wind from right to left as you look at it from the commentary box, but the conditions are perfect. It'll be hard ground, running rugby, I should expect. I'd expect a high-scoring game, although both teams will want to have a tight defence. I think they'll want to make sure that their attack's working well for next week's knockouts.
Yeah, hey Paul, hi Savi. Afternoon to everyone. Be interesting, I think, for these two teams, it's just about making sure they get on top of each other in today's match. It's always good to finish second and third. Last year, Havelocks were second place, and Navy were third. So of course Navy will want to go a step ahead, you know, a step further this season. We saw Candy yesterday taking the ultimate prize, yet again another title for Candy. And the question for these two teams, and you know, going forward, Havelocks were close, you know, so close, but so far last week against Candy. And we spoke about Candy being a little bit more professional when it comes to the big timers. But for these two teams, they're not too far off. Good to see some of the young Jamaica, you know, on the wing having a go. You know, it's good to see some of those youngsters having a go. But I think Navy might just have the edge today. Zabir, like Paul said, it's good conditions outside for open rugby. Referee Charles Brown, he's in charge again. Be a very physical encounter. Let's see how it works out, but I just think Navy might have the edge.
Well, we'll wait and see. Navy might have the edge, like Laga said. Let's have a look at the team cards first. The home team, skipper Roshan Ranasinghe, the experienced man, and Dulanjana Vijayasinghe, the Papari's most popular player award winner, and also Charit Silva in the front row. Stefan Gregory, interestingly, in the lock forward, and Adisha Veerathunga, former Isipathana player, joining Stefan in the lock. Kanchana Perera, experienced Danushka Perera, and Nivanka Prasad, loose forwards in fact, and Ruchi Dharmapala starting in the halfback. Chanaka Chandimal in the fly half, Supun Dilshan in the wing, Tanuja Madhuranga and Lahiru Herath in the centre combination, Hashan Madhuranga and Thilina Veerasinghe in the fullback position. Thilina of course needs another 18 points to clear the top point scorers. We'll talk about that. And Havelock's team card, Ashan Darling, Liston Flatney, Dushmanta Priyadarshan, the captain, Janik Jayasurya and Jason Miller in the lock combination, Senal Silva, Senal Dias and Lasindu Ishan Karunathilaka in the loose forwards. Sudham Suryarachi will start today ahead of Raul De Silva, Niroshan Fernando at the fly half, no Dulaj Perera today due to the injury, Chamara Dabare in the wing, Hiranta Perera and Nishan Perera in the centre combination, Chamika Kusal, Samaratunga in the wing, Kevin Dixon, the Sri Lanka under-20 captain, is in the fullback position. And let's have a look at the replacement. Hafiz Noor, Prasad Madhusanka, Udara Anjana, Sitam Piris, Rahul De Silva, Vimukta Rahula, Satara Basnayaka, Chanaka Bandara for Havelock Sports Club. And for Navy, it's Kasun De Silva, Nisal Desata, Chamit Madhusanka, Nirosh Pereira, Suranga Pushpakumara, the Little Magician, Sachin Kabe Sekora, Salia Handafangoda, and Gayan Vikramaratne, who toured Sri Lanka under-19 last year as well. And that's the team card. Looking at the team combination, Laga, is there anything why they picked Stefan Grigori from front row to lock forward?
Yeah, just probably want to counter what Havelock's will have with Jason on here, on the Havelock setup. And knowing Jartelica coaching Navy, they want to establish their foul play earlier on the piece and make sure they dominate up front and say their scrum. It's got to hold up a bit, you know, for the back of it, for 9 and 10 to be working off it. But I think it's just counter that and having their ball carriers, they'll have an extra ball carrier with Gregory.
There's the beautiful pictures. Here's the Navy team on your screen. Usual huddle and prayers just before the game. And like Laga saying, Navy has the edge fall. What do you reckon?
I think Navy playing at home is a big advantage for them. Their supporters will come as the game starts, as we see Heavy start running out, and they prepare for the game as well. But I know that Navy felt they were a little bit hard done by in the first round when they played Heavies at Havelock Park. They believe there's something owing to them here, and they're going to come with a lot of firepower and a lot of want and desire to make sure that they get the right result here today. So I actually think that it's going to be one up front to start off with. I think it's going to be a lot of forward play. The 9 and 10 for Navy are very experienced. Dharmabala and Chandamal, they control everything from the at 9-10 position. So they'll be very influential in this game.
The runner-up trophy will be lifted at the end of this game. And let's hope that...
And here's the Havelock's huddle, the men in pink and chocolate. And the
field will be as close as all the expectations.
Both teams getting prepared for the team introduction. You can see the trophy. That's the runners-up trophy. Dushmant Priyadarshana, the man with number 3 shirts on, will take that trophy. Because even though Navy win with a bonus point, without conceding one or two losing bonus points to Havelock, still they have to beat Havelock's maybe 100 points to nil, which is a tough task.
Well, it'll be a great game to watch if they win by 100 points to nil, Sevier.
Just waiting for the team introduction here from Valley Center grounds, and it's really hot and humid out here. And I'm sure the way Navy Sports Club played in their first leg, they will be a real contenders for the Dialog Clifford Cup knockouts, which will commence from the coming weekend, next Saturday and Sunday. That will be played at Race Course Grounds, and Candy will take on CHNFC. That's at Nitterwiller Grounds. Log on to www.thepuffery.com to get more information on that. And also, the school's rugby will commence in 2 weeks' time. 24th, 25th weekend, as the champions, Sipatana College, will travel to Dharmaraja College in Kandy to take on the first. As you can see, the team introduction.
Navy is led by Roshan Ransinga on their home ground. Coach Motilal Jayatilaka, supported by Dev Anand.
Navy team playing for pride, and they were in so much confident after beating Kandy Sports Club here in the first round game. It was 37 points to 31, but since then they just lost the track in the last two or three games. Surprisingly, Army Sports Club also beat Navy in their own den. So the team introduction is done, and it's all set for the kickoff. And like Paul predicts, we hope to see a high-scoring game. And too many changes coming in, like we mentioned, Dulaj Ferreira, who got injured in the Kandy game. He's missing. Probably he will miss the knockouts as well. From the coaching staff, that's the news that we got. And also, no Sudarshan Muthutantri, he was concussed in the Kandy game. And no Mithun Hapugoda as well. So, Chamika Kusala is starting, played for Sri Lanka under 20. Good to see Niroshan Fernando is starting in the pivotal fly half position. And Nishan Pereira, what a try he has scored against Kandy Sports Club, beating four defenders. That was simply brilliant, and the man in form. And here's a start as Niroshan Fernando kicks that straight into Navy's Sifun Dilshan. And Rishi Dharmapala sending it to Chanaka Chandimal. Opts to kick. I don't think that's a right kick. It's straight to Chamar Dabare. It just favors in favor of Navy Sports Club. Referee playing the advantage as Hashan Maduranga went almost 10 meters with the ball in hand. But the referee calls back to a play.
Well, Sabir, that's really not the start that that Havelocks would have wanted. I saw them before the kickoff when they were warming up. There were a lot of balls going up in the air, and there were a lot of balls being taken safely. So they definitely practiced it before the game started. But as soon as that ball went up in the air, it was wobbling around a little bit. The player was looking up and towards the sun as well, so it was difficult to take. He was unable to take it, and that's advantage Navy to start with.
Brilliant kick by Chanak Chandimal. He was marking that Chamar Dabare. Perhaps he's the weaker link on that side. Dabare, of course, a former Sri Lankan winger, was outstanding, but he lost momentum all of a sudden in the last couple of years. Have you coached Dabare, Laga?
Yes, of course. Well, you wouldn't be happy with that one. I don't think Janaka will intentionally kick at Dabare, but he won't be happy with that one. And almost resulted to disaster for Havelocks as Ishan collected that ball, but Jason was very quick to get on that ball, and it's a free kick, early engagement by Havelocks. So a quick tap is taken by Navy. Some good yards in the middle. They've gone back to where the scrum was. And look at that contact from Dusmanta. Go back, son.
Absolutely brilliant. Roshan Ratnagar, rather. That's a lovely pass. Here's Maduranga sending it an inside pass. Navy going strong. Stefan Gregory, and it's a try time. What a brilliant start for Navy Sports Club. Stefan Gregory scored that try. The big man starting as a lock forward for today's game. What a start, as Laga predicts.
Well, what a start. That's right, Sevier. But as he went through the hole and took the pass, he was still 30 metres out probably. And we saw him. He should have looked inside. There were players on the inside of support. We both shook our heads. We all shook our heads in the commentary box and thought, oh, no, he's gone the wrong way. But there was no stopping him there. As soon as he saw the white line, he was going to go over, as we see. We see the conversions being lined up now.
Yeah, we were too. You know, you're never happy as a coach when you see a front rower there playing second row. You know, when you see him there, we see the conversion gone through. So Navy there takes first blood straight on the board as we go into not even the second minute of the match. But as we're saying with Paul Craigie there, and having two guys on the inside, he should have passed that ball, but opted to go and take the fullback on Gregory versus Kunti, small man, and the big man wins.
Indeed, it's an interesting move, Laga, because Stefan Gregory in the first round and also in the most of the second round game, he was in the bench coming in the second half, but Coach Motilal Jayathilga making that change.
Yeah, for sure, he's a powerful lad, and another well-spotted kickoff by Havelocks, and they managed to win that one back. So Hilanta at the back of that goes out to Liston, 10 metres away, and again comes to Suryaraj, and he goes wide. You would think it's a bit outnumbered there, but Kunti is giving it out to Dabare, and just a bit lateral, and Kunti's not really doing enough with that ball, and just giving it to Dabare, the muscle man. Muscle man goes out.
The muscle man goes out. So good stuff by Havelocks, also showing some intensity to go that. Kevin Dixon with his first touch, I thought perhaps he could have made one or two steps to put some individual solo effort. We know how he's capable of. We have seen plenty in the St. Peter's jersey and also in the Sri Lanka under-20 jersey. However, Navy, brilliant defense on that occasion, Paul.
Yeah, that's right. That was good defense. They had the numbers there on that side, and it looked like in the backs that Heavy's only had three numbers on that side. So some of the backs got caught up in the initial breakdown.
That's not good by Navy. Good take by Jason Melder. And here's Havelocks. Niroshan Fernando with a long pass to Nishan Pereira. Trying to make a goose step. Kevin Dixon. And he was tackled.
Yeah, just running sideways there, Sabi. Yeah, it's got to be They're very clear what Havelocks are trying to do. Of course, they're trying to go around Navy. They've gone wide straight away. Their previous play, of course, Niroshan having two guys on the outside, and he opted to pass it to Kevin. And Kevin just went straight to Darbiter, and it found himself out. At this occasion here, same thing. He drifted, even he's on. They've got to make sure they create some faces. They've got to punch a bit more, eh? Just make sure, you know, commit a few numbers, get their forwards working. Otherwise, they go nowhere.
Well, maybe they're trying to move the Navy forwards from one side to the other side and try and tie them out. Although I'd be surprised if they can run this Navy forward pack off their feet.
Here we go, it's scrum time. Richie Dharmapala to feed the second scrum for Navy Sports Club.
Interesting, Zabi, we see Surya Raji just right in front of us. So a scrum inside the Navy 22 when you got halfback. And it's a penalty to Navy.
A penalty to Navy. Early. Holding on, says a referee. Referee Charlie Brown from Singapore. Did officiate in the Candy versus Havelocks game fortnights ago. Here's Chanaka Chandimal on his screen. With the touch as the ball just comes through the commentary box, and it's another line out.
Navy's got to make sure of this one. The first one, of course, they fumbled it and gave it away to Havelocks.
Dulanjana Vijay Singh didn't have a neat line out previously. Right opposite the other side of where he's throwing now. Here he goes now.
He did have all the votes for personality of the year, though, for the dialogue season.
That's well said. He's one of the strength by Navy Sports Club. Kasun Silva and Stefan Gregory going into contact. Jason Melder trying to turn over. Brilliant stuff by Melder. Here's the skipper, Dushmanta Priyadarshana, to Lasindushan. Here's Niroshan Fernando. Hiranta Pereira gets his hand in, and Nishan Pereira, two-on-one situation. And there goes Shamra Dabare, and Shamra Dabare just knocks it on, and he's not having his best of 7 minutes play.
Looks like he's got two left feet for hands there on that side. He's caught one ball, he's dropped two. Looked like he might have been in the clear too as well. He had a little slither of space down that try line, down that sideline. He really should have gotten through.
Yeah, there was a bit of space. It was only the cover defense, the winger, blindside winger for Navy that came across. So he just took his eyes to have a look at the defender. He managed to lose the ball there. But the creator there was Jason. You saw the first one. Jason just got on top of that ball and it was very hard to move it. For a body like that, you got to get underneath it. So the Navy's going to find it hard to move him if they're not going to take care of Jason earlier on the piece.
Here we go. Another scrum in favor of Navy Sports Club inside their red zone as Richie Dharmapala puts in. Nivanka Prasad sending it to Madhuranga. Madhuranga goes into contact. And Chandimal playing safety. Once again, it's that man, Chamara Dabare. Just ball passes him and a brilliant kick. Here's Kevin Dixon. Dixon puts that into touch.
It's a big territorial gain there for Navy. They've gone a long way. So they had a set piece over there in their own 22, and all of a sudden they find themselves well inside the Havelocks half, over the 10-metre line as well. So they're maybe 36 metres out from the try line.
Navy certainly won that battle of the kicking. Mia just finding space just behind Davida and putting that ball behind, so Kevin had to go back and finding themselves inside their half, just on a 40-meter line, and that was a good clean take by the Navy lock. And the drive keeping it very close, tight inside.
Good work in the line out by Adisha Veerathunga. Here's Dharmapala now to Chandimal. Chandimal to Madhuranga. Madhuranga steps and cuts inside. Former Science College player. And a switch of direction going for the shorter side by Navy Sports Club. Rishi Dharmapala. Again using the shorter side. Here's Nivanka Prasad now, the big man. Too many numbers committed in that ruck, but here's the skipper, Roshan Ransing, a twist and turn. He made some good 5 to 6 meters. That's a head neck roll, actually. Referee playing advantage. Here's Chandimal to Tilna Veerasinghe. Tilna steps and lovely fend and a lovely inside pass to Chanaka Chandimal. Unfortunate incident to Chanaka Chandimal as he knocks it on.
Jeez, that was very close, and that was well done by Tilna there. And that's what you need on the outside. You know, your edge, your boys on the edge to string their lines up. Put the fin. The fin came out. The offload came through, and yeah, it was just a bit unlucky there for Mir. He had his eye on the line there, but if he had on to that one, that was five-pointer.
Yeah, I think the ball just went a little bit behind him, and he just tried to catch it, and it's like grabbing onto someone's neck, and it just slipped out from under his between his arms. But it was a great bit of play there down the edge there, where they just straightened it up and went for that little half hole, got halfway through the gap, and then that gave him an opportunity to get his hands free, and he just flicked the ball on the inside. But obviously the referees brought them back for the penalty for offside by Havelock's, and Havelock's, their defence has been pushing very hard, so they're right on the offside line at the whole time.
Here's Tilna Weerasinghe. With this kick, hits the post, unfortunate for him. And here comes Havelock's, Sinal Dias. That's unlucky for Tilna Weerasinghe. Here's Liston Flatney to Losindu Ishan, running straight. Nishan Pereira going into contact. Brilliant work by Lai Ruherat, former Kannangara player. Here's Chandimal to Nivanka Prasad. Nivanka Prasad, rather. Here's the captain now, collecting that loose ball. Rishi Dharmapala to Chandimal to Madhuranga. Madhuranga with a long pass. Adisha Veerathunga. And he was put into touch.
Disappointing there. Navy had the numbers, but they instead threw a long cutout pass. It was a 4-on-2. And so if 4-on-2, you just need to keep running through your hands, like drawing pass, and make sure the defender has to make a decision, either stay on you or else go on the outside. And if he's going to go on the outside, you go through the hole. If he stays on you, then you just move the ball aside.
It was actually a good play from Navy, but it broke down when they trying to offload off that tackle in the middle there by the number 8. And it went backwards off the hands, so they had to tidy up.
Here's Flatney, taken well by Havelock's number 4, Sinal Dias. Here's Janik Jayasurya with his real first touch going into contact. Sudham Suryarachi knocks it on, but referee playing advantage in favour of Havelock's. Maybe a penalty incident, yep. He says a high tackle by Navy, pointing at the skipper, Roshan Ranasinghe.
So in that last passage of play, Lager, what I liked as well is when Navy had the ball and they turned it over, is the blindside winger came in straight away, and he was the first receiver. And that's what you need in counter-attack. You need the players to transition from defence to attack, and the first ones to transition, they win that battle, and they do well in the counter-attack.
Yeah, they have to do a lot of work now. The wingers, you know, they can't just stand back and watch, you know, and then that play there, even at turnover time, even in defense as well. So, yeah, well done by that Hishan coming in and taking that ball forward. So, and that was a penalty to Havelock's for the high shot. So, a bit of untidy ball from the lineout, and Suryaraja managed to get away from that tackle, and Chanik has lost that ball back, and the referee says no. So, Suryaraja decides to kick that back. And again, you find themselves against a bigger Navy hooker.
Big hit by Dushmanta Priyadarshan on Dulanjana Vijayasinghe, but here comes Adisha Veerathunga. He saw the space and made a very good yards out of it. And here's a Navy on the attack. Nivanka Prasad, good stuff by Nivanka Prasad. Great collection, going lower center of gravity, but conceding that penalty.
Yeah, that was unlucky there. There was space on the outside for that Navy attack, and the number 8 wasn't able to see that one. So Navy players there, just killing that ball, just getting off their feet.
The Havelock's line-out hasn't looked as sharp or as crisp as they have done previously. Like that, the last two line-outs for Havelock's, it looks like their timing's just a little bit out. The jumper's not at the top of their jump as he's collecting the ball. It looked like that time the wrong jumper actually collected the ball and tapped it back. But I like the pressure that Navy's bringing, and also Havelock's are bringing in defence as well. But that's encouraging for all wingers out there, that Coach Lager, Ford's coach, was commenting on how much work wingers do.
Here we go, another line-out with Liston Flatney. This time, once again, Dias takes it neatly. Surya Arachidu, Niroshan Fernando. Here's Hiranta Pereira. Kevin Dixon to Nishan Pereira to Chamara Dabare. Dabare goes into contact, sets up nicely this time around. In the far corner, Surya Arachi to Fernando. Here's Jason Melder pumping his legs. Another good run, good running angle by Liston Fatney. Surya Arachi. Surya Arachi saws the space, and Surya Arachi gives to the captain Dushmanta Priyadarshana. Havelock's taking their time. Niroshan Fernando, here's Dias. Dias tried to go by himself. He was supported well by Havies. Surya Arachi to Flatney. And Havelock still with the position this time, sending it to Jayasurya. Lasindu Ishan screaming for the ball. Here's Kevin Dixon. And this time, Hiranta Pereira, can he score from the far corner? No, brilliant defense by Navy Sports Club. Absolutely brilliant defense on that occasion. It's not the first time they did. And that's brilliant work by Chandimal as well. He knew the penalty is going to come.
Yeah, that was a bit better passage of play by Havelock's. Just their big boys, Liston and Duswanta and Janik, just taking the ball straight up. Shahan there found himself on the outside channel, took the ball up, managed to retain it. Again, they went into the middle, and I thought Hiranta there was over the line, but he lost the ball forward, so they just need to finish.
Yeah, they looked a little bit bunched in the middle, I thought, in the middle of that attack, though. Havelock's, they're not stretching Navy as I thought they might. They looked like they were stretching them right at the beginning of the game, where they're sending it from one side to the other. Then in this last attack, they put all the players in the middle and they looked a little bit too bunched. If they can just spread out a little bit, they might be able to find some space on the outside.
Here we go, a pressure scrum though. Rishi Dharmapala to Nivanka Prasad. Sends it to Madhuranga. Good defense by Havelock's. Chandimal will look to put this ball into touch. Dulanjana Vijay Singh acting as scrum half, and Chandimal does that so well to come out of 22. That's brilliant stuff by the experienced Chandimal.
Yeah, it was a nice looking exit there. So what they do is they send it straight to the number 12 channel, and he sort of takes it into contact, and the forwards can get around, and it gives them a little bit more time. It buys the time for the kicker. The forwards can all also collect around the ruck, and they can spread out the ruck so that the chasers have a more difficult job getting through to the kicker as well.
Another Havelock's line out with Liston Flatney. And this time, again, Senal Dias taken nicely. And here goes that driving. Mall Dushmanta Priyadarshana controlling it. And Liston Flatney breaks. Good tackle. Here's Surya Arachi to Fernando. A lovely decoy running by Hiranta Pereira, but instead, Fernando sending it to Nishan Pereira. Too many numbers in that ruck, and Surya Arachi to Flatney. Almost knocked it on, but good skills by Flatney. Here's Melder. He needs support. Surya Arachi to Fernando. Fernando to Nishan Pereira. Nishan Pereira. Still not finding a way to go past that Navy defensive line. Very compact line by Havelock's. They're attacking very straight line. And here's space now. Senal Dias to Hiranta Pereira. Havelock still with position. Dushmanta Priyadarshana, a long pass by Sudham Surya Arachi. Kasun Silva and Stefan Grigori combining for that tackle. Here's Flatney to Fernando. Fernando to Lasindu Ishan. Oh, big hit coming in. Referee says play on. And Havelock still on the march now. Still inside the 22. Surya Arachi to Melder. Melder to Dushmanta Priyadarshana, the captain. Here's Chamaradabare with a long pass to Hiranta Perera. Somehow Havelock's found that space. And Hiranta Perera scoring the first try to Havelock's. So 7 points to 5 with the conversion to come.
Yeah, well done to Havelock's. I thought their one-off runners was were getting stuck at times, but just that last, the previous to second to last play there, Jason transferring the ball, shifting the ball on the outside to Tusmanta, found space. I thought if he had shifted one more time, there was space on the outside with Shahan, but managed to recycle that ball, and they were always going to find space on the outside, like how Paul was saying earlier on, and good time for them to come back.
Yeah, that's right. It was a good time to come back, but I tell you what, Lager, Fat Man's Alley was pretty crowded there. Everyone is in the middle, just going straight up and down the middle of the field. And you're right in recognising that Jason Mulder just shifting the ball there. He took the ball into contact a couple of times, and he attracts defenders towards him. So that time when he attracted the defenders, he just moved it once more. And I saw Liston Flatney as well. He did that as well. He shifted the ball once as well. So I think that might be a play that they're doing where they take the ball into contact a few times, they bring the defenders towards them, and then the next time they have the ball, they just shift it a little bit and shift the point of attack, and it worked that time for Havelock's. Conversion wasn't successful, so it's 5 points all.
5 points to seven. Hiranta Perera misses that conversion, try scorer. Good to see he's coming into the form. Played for Isipathana College and also a Sri Lanka Sevens team under Matt Turner, the coach. And also join me on the Back to the Boat segment where I bring all the technical and tactical analysis of this Dialogue Club Rugby League, and that will be uploaded on the puffery.com by Wednesday. You can see which team did it right and what went wrong for the teams. And here we are back live now as Thilina Weerasinghe puts that huge kick, lovely take in the air by Sinal Dias. Sudam Suryarachi to Dushmanta Priyadarshana. That's a bit high tackle, correctly so, playing advantage. And Jason Melder picks the ball and run. Brilliant stuff by the big man. It was not a good offload, but referee coming back to the initial high tackle infringement. Nowadays the law has been changed for the high tackle, Paul.
Yeah, that's right. So that there are two new classifications for that law. There's a dangerous tackle and there's an accidental tackle. So that was obviously an accidental tackle. It was just, looks like he started high and just went a little bit high. And there, Havelock's got a little bit lucky there. The ball bounced out from that kick. So they'll retain the ball and get to have the throw-in because the ball went out from that kick. But and then Jason Melder just took the ball up straight through the middle. It looked like everyone stopped playing, although when he went through and he sort of held off the contact, he ended up getting spun around, so it's very difficult to run backwards.
And that's a brilliant work by Jason Melder. He likes, he supports England, and he must be watching Nathan Hughes, how he does from the breakdown, pick that ball and run when the opposite wall is isolated.
Well, that's not bad, Sabir. 20 minutes into the game and you're mentioning England.
Here we go.
We did well to stay away from England that long.
Havelock's controlling and it collapsed now. Still the position. Sudam Suryarachi with a lovely long pass. And Roshan Fernando trying to cut through that 12 and 13 defense. But Nishan Pereira gets the loose ball and scores the second try. So things all of a sudden going in favor of the men in pink.
Well, it looked like they were passing to each other. They one man in pink passed to a man in blue, passed it back to a man in pink. Great hands by all three of them, but the ball ended up in the hands of the Nishan Pereira, and he went over and next to the post, so I'd imagine this will be going over. So as I said before the game, it's probably going to be a high scoring match with both attacks trying to get at the other defence, but also there'll be at some point I expect Navy will show a little bit more heart than they have at the moment. They need to hold on to the ball for a little bit longer and start playing some rugby. Well done by Havelock's.
Yeah, it was actually Niroshan, the flyer for Havelock's, decided to take that line there. So he went through the cap and the offload was on. He popped it back to Hiran, and the centre for Navy got in the way, had the ball in his hand, and then he popped it out again. He popped it to one of his centres, and Nisan straight away got in the middle of that. Picked his luck there and got the 7 points for Havelock's.
Good conversion this time by Hiranta Perera. We saw that Fazil Marja doing yesterday, taking in to the opposite 10 and 12, and lovely offload coming into Rishad Dharmapala, I reckon.
Yeah, it's combinations, really. You know, you got to, sometimes as a centre, you know, you got to get put yourself in the right spots, you know, to win some of those moments. And he's on there, he certainly put himself in between the players, yeah. So for the Navy centre, all he had to do is hold on to that ball and keep it. It was right in front of their post as well.
Maybe a little inexperienced by little Tanuja Maduranga, but here's the restart. Lassin Dishan collects it. At instant, he thought it could have called by someone else, but here's Havelocks now. Will Sudam give this to Niroshan Fernando? Fernando puts it deep. Tilna Veerasinghe not timing that kick. Veerasinghe with the attack now. Last year's highest point scorer. Here's Dulanchana Vijayasinghe. That's high. That's high by Sinal Dias. And the referee, Charlie Brown, having a word with the assistant referee. Number four, penalty only, says referee.
At some point, he'll probably have to have a word to the both sets of players to make sure that they keep their tackles down. Navy have decided to take a shot at goal. So Veerasinghe, he's got a great boot. He's scored a lot of points this season. He's got a little bit of wind behind him. He's still on a wide angle. So I'd say this would be, 56 metres maybe?
Yes, with the angle, Paul, but interesting move because he moves now. He has 156 points and just 16 points needed to pass Dulaj Pereira. If that happens today at the end of the game, regardless of the results of the match, Tilna Veerasinghe will be awarded for the, top point scorer in the Dialogue Rugby League.
Of course, Dulaj Pereira is not playing today. He was injured last week against Kandy. So the crowd, there's a hush in the crowd as he takes this one last look at the posts.
I'm sure Hashan Maduranga will charge this, the winger. And this time the kick looks good. That's a brilliant kick.
It's a brilliant kick and you could hear it. I could hear it from the commentary box. The contact was so sweet. It was a beautifully sounding kick. Went straight through the posts. The distance wasn't a problem. He could have gone back a couple of metres as well. But, that's dangerous for Havelocks anywhere in their half, that means. Anywhere at all in their half. They give away a penalty and this man can have a shot at goal.
So just a 2 points of margin now for the home team Navy. 10 points to 12 in favour of Havelocks. Here's Niroshan Fernando. Adisha Veerathunga collects the ball and pushes Ashan Darling. Rishi Dharmapala sending it to Chandimal. It's taken out. The kick cannot be gone into the full out. Chamika Kusal make a blunder with that high ball. What a brilliant kick once again. Is it almost a try? Almost a try. Very good chase by Supun Dilshan. And here's the counter-attack by Havelocks. And Chamar Dabare puts that kick into touch.
Well, that's a funny shaped ball, isn't it? It looked like that ball was... It travelled over the head of the winger, then it bounced towards the sideline. Everyone thought, oh, it's going to go out. There's a great kick. Then it bounced, stayed in. And then it looked like it was going to be in trouble. The Havelocks were going to be in real trouble, but they managed to run it back out.
How good that chase by Supun Dilshan, Laga?
Oh, he was about inches away there from scoring a five-pointer for his team. But young Javika there was a bit shaky under that ball, and he was too far inside. And when he went backwards, he wasn't too sure whether the ball was going to go on. And the best thing you got to do there as a young player is just to kick it out, restart. And that's what Dabare did. And here comes Navy again inside Havelock's half, just punching it out straight from the line out. And they're on the Havelock's 22, and yet they've gone back to where the ball came from.
Hishan Maduranga fumbles, but still with position, Navy. Here's the captain, Ranasinghe. Good hit, and Dharmapala, it's a knock-on. Knock-on by Havelocks, few hands coming in on that ruck.
There's a great run there by the hooker from Navy, Dulanjana. He He came around, he threw the ball in, and he just took off straight away, and he collected the ball. It came off the top and got around the line out, and he managed to get right over the advantage line and into the number 10 and into the inside backs of Havelock's. And that's a dangerous time because you get those inside backs involved, and then if they can turn the ball over quickly, it means that in the backs you've got less numbers. And so I actually thought Navy should have come open instead of going blind.
Yeah, it's usually the case, though. Once you get a big guy, your vigilant singer there, the skipper, carry the ball over the advantage line, you'll expect the forward to come around, stay flat, and then take it again. And that's the best way you can run off your backs off it, because, you know, if you go another 5-6 meters after that, you'll open out wide straight away. So it's just a bit of game management, you know, how the players can read the play.
Yeah, there's that, as well as if they can turn the ball over even quicker before the forwards can get around the other side, then you've got one back less, or maybe even two backs if he can get to the 12, and then you're just defending with a 13, a 15 and a winger, and you're against the whole back line, and it's very difficult to get your players around. So the forwards have to get around the other side of that ruck before that advantage can be taken advantage of.
Another penalty for Tilna Weerasinghe. What a beautiful kick he made the previous one. It's a tough angle. Here's Weerasinghe, puts that kick through. What a beautiful stuff by Tilna Weerasinghe. So Navy takes the lead now, 13 points to 12.
Yeah, just got to be cautious now. Havelock's giving away penalties inside the half, because it looks like Tilna today's got his kicking boots on. Of course, they practice here every day, so you'll have a better knowledge of the field better than some of the most of the kickers that comes into Velisala.
Here's the restart now. Dulanjana Weerasinghe goes into contact. Dharmapala controlling things nicely. Here's this man. No pressure whatsoever for Chanaka Chandimal. Not good work by Havelock's forwards. Brilliant kick. Sudham Suryarachi seems like he's not interested on taking that high ball. Here's Rishi Dharmapala. Dulanjana to Madhuranga. A lovely pass to Tanuja Madhuranga. Hiranta Perera tackles. Nivanka Prasad trying to pick and run, but he just could not hold on to the ball. Here's Madhuranga. A long pass by Dharmapala. Looks like that's a knock forward.
It looked like they might have been going the wrong way. I thought that, the opportunity might have been to go on the open side. But it looked like the forwards were all decided to camp on the far side away from our commentary box. And that's where the halfback, Richie's going back towards that side. But I thought there might have been more space on the closest side, on the open side. And that might have been where the opportunity was.
A bit too far back. They did well in the middle there, just to punch the ball in the middle. And that's where you want to be, you know, in the middle of the field. Then you get two sides, but choosing which way to go, that might be a problem. But they went too far back, and those forwards lost the ball on the side and gave away a vital position there. So it's a steady scrum by Havelock's in the ocean, giving it to Hiranta, and again bringing this on back inside. And they've gone a bit wider, and Kunti there just giving it to Jamika. Pass just went behind him. And the linesman had his flag up.
Unfortunate once again. Kusal just could not time his run. It's a brilliant work by Kevin Dixon also, but unlucky. Kosala Tisera, the Navy Sports Club centre, he just found the whitewash in the sidelines.
He just put his foot out there, but as they were coming across, the hands looked excellent from Havelock's. It looked like the ball was going... It was crisply going from one the passer straight to the hands of the receiver, but the last pass from Kevin Dixon was a little bit behind, a little bit off the mark. So you need to make sure that every single pass in the back line is going to go exactly where it needs to go, in front of the man with his hands up and taking the ball, running onto it.
And the referee stops the clock. He's having a word, maybe a blood... Blood bin Jason Melder. Looks like he's bleeding. And also the big match season is on us, and the busiest place is the Pufferi.com, preparing to bring you live action from the grounds. Catch the live matches, updates, photos, reviews, interviews, and all the March Madness stuff. Cricket Big Match season is here. Log on to www.thepopper.com for more information, and this is not a good sign.
The two men bringing on the stretcher, I've never seen two more hopeful men. They're hoping that Jason Mulder can walk off. They're not carrying him off. Very relieved to see him walking away.
Did you walk away with a stretcher, Laga, during your era?
Never went down, Sabine, never went down, brother. But, yeah, that would be a loss for Havelock's. Let's hope he's okay. I think it's a concussion test. And with the ruling now, you're very strict. You've got to be very careful with the hits. So referee Charlie Brown has done the right thing there. And as Paul was saying about the stretcher, yeah, you wouldn't want to carry 120 kilos with two small guys on that yellow stretcher. But Jason is a tough boy, finding himself out there. But who's going to last this this heat, Paul Savia? You know, that's a team that's going to come out well in this one, in this contest. It was quite even right now, 13-12.
Absolutely. It's hot and humid. We're melting down in the commentary box, so as the players in the ground, but Situmpir is replaced for the time being until Jason Melda finish his HIA test. Here's Dharmapala. Nivanka Prasad, the front row was already up, referee playing advantage. Nivanka Prasad breaking from that back of the scrum, not a good pass. However, Supun Dilshan opts to kick this. And there's another knock on. And the referee continues the play. It's a good thing. Initially he was playing the advantage, but here comes Dushman, the Priyadarshana. Numbers out wide, hands not need, Navy Sports Club. Here's Dulanjana, Nivanka Prasad to Dharmapala, and Adisha Veerathunga. Turnover ball, Kevin Dixon with the attack. He's trying to beat few defenders, but good defense on that occasion. Navy all the way into the opposite red zone now. Sudam Suryarachi to Niroshan Fernando. 2-on-1, lovely draw and pass. Here's the try scorer, Hiranta Pereira. Good tackle coming in. Referee says play on. Navy have the advantage now. A slight knock-on on that occasion. So it's all, everything happening here at the Valley City grounds, Paul.
It's total helter-skelter rugby. The ball's going from one side to the other. It looked like Navy might have had an opportunity down both sides of the, at both flanks. The ball got turned over. Kevin Dixon did very well to come out with the ball. Havelock seemed to look like they were almost going to break out down the other side. The ball was knocked on at that point. But I thought right at the beginning there might have been a penalty, or it looked like the referee was playing advantage, but he decided that the advantage had accrued and he decided to play on. But it's barbarian style rugby, isn't it, really? They're throwing the ball around. There's lots of opportunities. It's great to watch.
Indeed, it's great to watch. And here's another scrum. Dharmapala, another penalty. Havelock's very poor on that set piece.
Yeah, it's a new... it's not a new... For Havelock's, you got Liston starting at hooker, Sabia, so you still got Ashan Darling and Duswanter on the front row, but the referee there has penalised Darling for going back inside. So yet another opportunity for Tilina to push their lead out to four. But yeah, interesting, down outside, just in front of us, Paul, it was a scrum again. The referee called advantage for one of the Havelock's centre breaking too early from the scrum. It's played on, and then number 8 from Navy is carrying the ball quite well. But that centre for Navy, Lytle, impressive. He got outside there and tidy up the ball there. That Stubbard knocked it on, and he got in the outside and tidied that one up. And he won that, I'm not too sure, from where we are, the referee said played on, so he came on the side and forced that knock on. They won in the scrum, and now penalty, and could be 3 points for Navy.
Time is ticking. We are heading to the half time, and sensible play. If your kicker can kick 50 plus meters, why not take this as still Weersinger? Let's see. That looks good, but unfortunately, this time around, it's just out of the right uprights. So the score remains 13 in favor of Navy, 13-12. It's a 22 restart. We can see Niroshan Fernando asking the referee. Perhaps this could be the last play. And it was straight into that man, Lahiru Herat. He beats again Janik Jayasurya and Ashan Darling. Dulanjana knocks it back. Another long pass to Hishan Maduranga. Brilliant work by Navy. Still holding on to that position. Roshan Ranasinghe going into contact. Dharmapala needs to send it quickly. Numbers out wide. Chandimal puts that chip, actually. Good defense by Chamika Kusal. Unfortunately, Lairo Herat knocks it on.
Referee Charlie Brown has a look at his watch. Says it's time for one more scrum, fellas. You're not going inside the sheds for a rest yet.
That's a lovely kick, isn't it, Laga?
I'm not so sure what went through his head, but he should have kept the ball in hand. I mean, it took about a second or two for the ball to travel on the outside. He actually had three guys on the outside, so, but they were too flat for him to, you know, for him to pass, so that's why he kicked it. But if the ball had got to the outside, that would have been trouble for Havelocks. Chambika there did really well just to stay with the man, make sure he made the tackle. Maybe a couple more plays for the first half.
Indeed, few numbers out wide for Navy. And here's Saddam Suryarachi sending it to Fernando, to Hiranta Pereira. Nishan Pereira runs inside. Lovely step by Hiranta Pereira. Can he go all the way? And lovely offload to Kevin Dixon. And Kevin Dixon is going to score that try. A brilliant running angle by Hiranta Pereira.
Wow, that was a lovely angle. He just drifted outside his defender and then straightened up. Sort of looked like he was going to pass, and as soon as the hole opened up in front of him, he just stepped on the accelerator and he was straight through. He found Kevin Dixon running a great line on the outside as well, and he managed to get over it before the cover defense came across. So really, that was a great backsplay straight from a set piece. And that's where the majority of tries are scored from, first phase or straight off the set piece or straight off a turnover. Often coaches like to play phase play, but really, if you can be direct and find the hole and then go straight through, you can score before the cover defense gets across, and that's what Havelocks did just then.
Absolutely brilliant run on that occasion. Also, Kevin Dixon, good to see. Finally, he's putting some score on the board.
Yeah, well, that's just what they needed, right? This will give them a lot of push in the second half. Havelocks, you know, getting on top of the scoreboard. Going into the Priva, but lovely work. The first time we've seen Hiranta run. I mean, he's a big boy. If he starts running like that, hitting the holes like that, he's unstoppable. And when he holds the ball up in two hands, and that was a lovely, just a one-hand offload to Kevin. So we see the conversion not so good from Hiranta. So the score stays at 17-13.
17-13, and that's the halftime. It's a brilliant stuff by Havelocks to score that last second try just before the half time. There's plenty of action remaining in the second half also under this hot and humid condition. What do you think would be the message inside the dressing room by coach Motilal Jayasinghe?
Well, look, I think he'll be happy to get them back inside, and just he'll be able to have a look at what the Navy team are doing. So what I'm thinking is that I'm seeing Havelocks, and they're very narrow in their defense and their attack. If Navy can make sure that when they're setting their numbers, they can set a little bit deeper, they might be able to get the ball around the outside of the edge of the Havelocks defence, and they'll be able to go around the outside of them.
So that's the score, 17 points to Havelocks, 13 for Navy at the halftime. As Navy march is on the field as the players take the lemon. And don't go anywhere. We'll be right back after the break with the second half action. We are bringing you live from Vallisetra as a Navy taking on Havelocks.
Welcome to Hope Centric Yoga. I'm your host, Hope. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe to thepopery.com. Special thanks to Body Bar for the location and iPhone Sri Lanka for the video production. Follow me on Instagram at featherpalm_fox.
The Recap, your daily sports update. Wherever you are, tune in to thepopery.com at 6:30 p.m. on the dot and be updated on what happened around you.
I'm Mishru, this is Natasha. We are Revolution Athletes and we are the founders of Fit.lk.
So basically, we're partnering with the Papare to bring you a mini series called Workout Right Fit.lk. We're gonna help educate you on how to get the most out of your workouts, and not only that, we're gonna motivate you through the fitness journey you're about to start. So stay tuned.
Welcome to Hope Centric Yoga. I'm your host, Hope. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe to thepaparay.com. Special thanks to Body Bar for the location and iFilm Sri Lanka for the video production. Follow me on Instagram at featherpalm_fox.
The Recap, your daily sports update. Wherever you are, tune in to thepaparay.com at 6:30 p.m. on the dot and be updated on what happened around you.
Second ODI between Sri Lanka and Australia. Australia leading the series 1-0. The news is that Angelo Matthews has won the toss.
This is Natasha. We are Revolution Athletes and we are the founders of Fit.lk.
So basically, we are partnering with the Paparay to bring you a mini series called Workout Right Fit.lk. We're going to help educate you on how to get the most out of your workouts. And not only that, we're going to motivate you through the fitness journey you're about to start. So stay tuned. Get fit the right way.
Welcome to Hope-Centric Yoga. I'm your host, Hope. Thanks for watching. Do subscribe to thepaparay.com. Special thanks to Body Bar for the location and iFilm Sri Lanka for the video production. Follow me on Instagram at featherpalm_fox.
The Recap, your daily sports update. Wherever you are, tune in to thepaparay.com at 6:30 p.m. on the dot and be updated on what happened around you.
Second ODI between Sri Lanka and Australia. Australia leading the series 1-0. The news is that Angelo Matthews has won the toss.
Welcome back to the Wellington Grounds. This is Dialogue Rugby League final week actions between Navy Sports Club versus Havelock Sports Club. It's been an absolutely cracking first half, which we saw here. And Havelock's, thanks to that last minute try just before the halftime by Kevin Dixon, with courtesy of Hiranta Pereira's absolutely run. And that's sealed 17 points to 13 at the halftime. And all set for the second half action. We can see on your screen Danish Kapira having a word with the referee, Charlie Brown from Singapore. He was here before doing the Havelocks versus Kandy game as well, fortnights ago. And here's the restart, Thilna Weerasinghe. Very good kick, Adisha Weerathunga almost collected that, but unfortunately knocks it on. Also joining me in the commentary, same person in the first half, it's Paul Toya and Tulagisi Tavita. That's a good start.
Yeah, that was a great start there. It was a difficult catch, but you know, every time you play Navy, when they kick off, the kickoffs are so precise. They put the ball up really high. They get a good chasing line through. It's difficult to take their kickoffs, and it's an area that all teams who are going to play them, they need to work on as they come up to the game.
Laga, what do you think the message at the halftime in the dressing rooms by Coach Motilal Jayatilaka?
Oh, they need to score first in the second half. I think they'll need to not throw the 50-50 passes and make sure they take their opportunity. Apart from that, they were a bit unlucky to be behind in the scoreboard, but you got 40 minutes now.
Supun Dilshan going into contact, made few yards, brilliant yards. Kasun De Silva, the big prop forward. Richie Dharmapala needs some quick balls out wide, and that's a brilliant tackle too, but good hit as well. Chandimal to Dulanjana, lovely break by Dulanjana Vijayasinghe. Two on one, here goes Tanuja Maduranga. Can he finish it off? He's taking us on Kevin Dixon, and a brilliant tackle coming in by Havelocks. Lovely break by Dulanjana Vijayasinghe. Here goes Navy into the 5 meter mark. Just a 3 meter shot now. Rishi Dharmapala marshalling his troops. Stefan Gregory, the big man who scored the first try. Navy needs some patience. Havelock needs some patience in the defensive line as well. Dulanjana Vijayasinghe almost scored that try, but the ball comes out wide. Two on one, should have sent it before. Looks like try being scored by the Navy center. It's not sure as the referee having a word with his assistant referee. No try, says referee. It was the man who touched down Lahiru Hera, the Navy center. But quite unfortunate. But what a brilliant passage of play. Dulanjana Vijayasinghe running that 15 to 20 meters. But Tanuja Maduranga could have finished it, or he had support into his left, isn't it, Paul?
I thought Dulanjana probably should have drawn the man a little bit closer to him before he sent the ball away. He gave it a little bit early. But often that's what you want your front rowers to do, to give it to the back first and then he can do something. Really, they should have scored there. They're still hard on attack.
It's not a steady scrum. Havelocks with a pressure scrum inside their red zone.
Yeah, it really showed the space in defense where the holes are. It's just outside the second receiver. So when he shifted that ball there, you know, as two passes, there was a massive space in the middle of the Havelock's defense.
Havelock's number 8 breaks. Lasindu Ishan. Rattled by Navy, but looks like that's offside play. And that's Chanaga Chandimal. No arms. Not bound, maybe. So a good opportunity for Havelocks to come out of jail.
Yeah, look, I thought Havelocks really dodged a bullet there. When you saw Dulanjana go through that hole, it looked like it was curtains for Havelocks, but they managed to hold them out. There was desperate defense. Now they get a penalty to relieve the pressure. They're almost up to the halfway line. Great scrambling defense, great desperation. Navy really, as Lug was saying earlier, Navy are the ones that need to score first. They need to get back on the scoreboard straight away. So Havelock's did really well to hold them out.
That's a good kick as well by Fernando. Now Havelock's playing with the wind, so he can make that territorial kick extra yards, especially with the help of the wind.
Flattening about to throw the ball in. It looks like he's a surfer that's just come back from Hikidua.
He's got one of those haircuts.
Here goes Fernando now. That's a very good kick. Madhuranga collects it nicely and calls it Mark. Good collection under pressure. Also, yeah, the sun. Good stuff by Madhuranga. Taking it quickly and sending it to Thilina. That's not a good kick at all. Here's Shamika Kusal. Shamika Kusal steps. Havelock's forwards good support on that occasion. Captain Dushmant Priyadarshan acting as halfback. Another good dummy. Great turnover by Navy player. But unfortunately, he knocks it on. Again, I think it's that man, Lairu Herath, who made that turnover.
Yeah, he did well there to manage to show the referee a little bit of daylight. I didn't manage to see it, but the referee must have. But he got straight over the ball, quickly grabbed it. But he was unable to get the ball back and maybe get into a position where he could secure the ball back and make a long place. But it was a weird clearance by Navy, actually, after that safe kick. I actually thought that it's a free kick, and as soon as you put the ball on the ground, that means it's the beginning of play, so you can start charging him down.
Here's Sudham Suryarachi now, sending it to Fernando. Nishon Pereira. Nishon Pereira, a good tackle coming in by Madhuranga. Tanuja Madhuranga and Hashan Madhuranga combining that and putting Nishon Pereira out from the touchline.
Yeah, you just feel that Roshan has to take the line a bit more. Just hoping to give the ball out to Nizan and waiting for him to make some space. I mean, to punch out a bit wider. And drift defense these days are very, very, very wrapped up, very organized. So just need to punch one or two holes and give themselves some space. One line out by Navy just on their 22, keeping the drive, keeping the ball in the middle there. He's broke away from it.
Good take by Kanchan Ferreira from that line out. Navy's lock forward. Here's Nivanka Prasad. He should have gone a bit lower. And Dharmapala puts that box kick straight into Chamar Dabare. He's not having a good day at all. And Kevin Dixon. It's not a good kick either. Here's Thilina Veerasinghe says thank you very much. And all the way Navy now with position. Rishi Dharmapala with a quick ball. There's a gap coming in. Brilliant run by Navy.
Yeah, it was that man Lider again that broke the tackle and went through. It just needed some support. Still Navy has possession of the ball, and Jason there got on top of it very quickly. The referee has his hand out, so Janaka there just seeing the space at the back and popping it at the back. He got some chases. You've got a fullback and a lock there for Havelock, so the referee will come back to the penalty. But that was a waste of position, really, you know, for you would have think you'd keep the ball in hand when you have that sort of momentum.
Yeah, so basically when it's advantage like that, it's a penalty advantage, you've got a free shot. So you can do whatever you want, and you kick the ball away is really, you know, it's like you're not really playing your cards right. You've sort of throwing your hand in there, and really what you need to do is just hold on to the ball and try something other than just kicking the ball. As we can see Stephen Gregory getting helped off the ground. Stephen Gregory's way too big. The stretcher doesn't even attempt to come on and help him off.
He had a good game, isn't it, Paul, scoring that first try right away from the start. He's been brilliant, former St. Joseph's player.
Yeah, I thought he was a little bit quiet after that try. I thought he might have come in and bossed the game a little bit more, dominated contact a little bit more. But we can see as we're lining up for the kick here and the crowd goes quiet,
Maybe it's going on in his mind that he's not playing as prop, he's playing as a lock forward today. Unfortunately, Thilina Weerasinghe misses that kick as well. So he missed three already. And he's just 10 points away from the top point scorer to beat Dulaj Ferreira.
Well, he's got to think about kicking 3 points for his team first to start with. But yeah, we go back to what Paul said. That advantage there by Janica, by Mir, you know, he should have used the ball in because they're behind by 17, 30 by 4 points. So they need a try just to get in front. And that's the result of it, a penalty being missed. They recovered the ball back, and he's taking it to the lane, winning it back in the middle. Again, they've gone the same way. Skipper Weerasinghe there doing very well on the carries, and Janik trying to bring him down there. Again, they've come into the middle. So, yeah, they've gone back to where he came from, and those guys on the outside are just a bit too flat. So, ball has come straight out of that ruck, and the linesman has his flag up. So,
quite unfortunate by Navy.
But if I was a Navy centre, I'd be looking out here and I'd be seeing Jason Melder, and there was another front rower, maybe Darling, here out in the middle. And if you see those two big boys here and you're a centre, you'd be thinking, this is happy days, because, you know, I can use my footwork, my pace, and I can get at those guys. So they need to start recognising where weaknesses are in the defensive line and start attacking those areas. And as a centre, you should be telling your number 10, this is where we need to go. Give me the ball. Give me a shot at these guys.
One more replacement. Chamara Dabare goes off, and Vimukti Rahula comes to replace Dabare.
Navy's still got to keep the pressure on now, but you would think, the referee are blowing his whistle there, but you would think the pins will play a big part in this one, boys, as we see a change from the Havelock's Havelock's bench. We spoke to off-air, Paul, about using some of your key players, you know, off the bench. You know, Rahul will play a big part if he counts on, you know, in this sort of scrappy occasion. He might be the man just to put it in place.
Yeah, I think you're right there, Lager. He'll give them some direction as Havelock's trying to bring the ball out. They've just been stolen by Dulanjana. He's going to score under the post, and this is exactly what you need from your leader.
And that looks like Nivanka Prasad, the man who scored that try, but the referee
actually
turned over. Not sure. Referee says play on.
I think he might have just ran the ball over the
dead ball area.
The dead ball line. Terrible mistake. I know how he feels. I've done that before.
Well, that's a cardinal error. It's his home ground. He should be knowing that where the deadline area is.
That's going to come back to haunt him for sure, but that was brilliantly done by the Navy number 8. He stole the ball off Chasen, I think, at Dulange. Yeah, he stole the ball, just stripped the ball off him, and he just ran, fended his way through and went over the line, and he got over the dead ball line, and that could be very costly.
Costly at the bar later on tonight, I'd imagine, eh, Larka, when you run over the dead ball line, and you should score a try.
But that's a poor restart by Havelock's, kicking out on the full. And here's another opportunity for Navy. That's their strength, driving. Still controlling well, Havelock's. And Dulanjana Weerasinghe breaks from that maul. Havelock's trying to hold him up. And here's the big Kassam De Silva. They have a space onto the right as Rishi Dharmapala to Adisha Weerathunga. Adisha steps, and good support coming in for Navy. Another pick and drive. Jason Melder trying to defend. Navy, it's all about management now. Here's a long pass from Chandimal. It's a lovely step by Thilina Weerasinghe to the center, Lahiru Herat. Dharmapala sending it to Weerasinghe. Navy still inside the 5 meter mark. Another good run by Dulanjana. Good defense so far by Havelock's. A long pass to Chandimal. Chandimal with another long pass, and it was taken by Thilina Weerasinghe. And Weerasinghe has his touchdown. Referee will have a word with the linesman. No try given, and Thilina Weerasinghe, it's that man who missed two penalties and a conversion, but it doesn't matter if you can score 5 points to your team.
Well, he knows how to get over the try line. It's not the first time that maybe you've been over the try line in the last couple of minutes, but this is the first time they're going to be awarded a try. It's great attack there by Navy. They held onto the ball, they had width, they were hitting the ball up through the middle. And if they have a look at the Havelock's defence, after they've gone into attack, they'll be able to, all they need is their attackers just to lift their eyes up and have a look, and they'll be able to see who they need to attack. You see some big men and two and three and out by the first receiver, you just get the ball outside them and there's holes there for Havelock. So well, it'll be interesting to see if Navy can find those holes and take advantage of it.
Yeah, it was just the inexperience of the winger there, young Jamika there, just came in between there. It looked from where we're sitting, Paul, Sabir, it looked like Dillina was on the ground and then he reached out for the line again, but the referee was closer than where we are. But Jamika there came, pushed his luck there, came in between, didn't catch the ball, it went over his head, hit his hands and then went over his head. And Dillina did well there just to hold on to the ball and get Navy over the line.
And once again, he missed that conversion. So he missed 10 points today with his kicking boots, Paul.
Yeah, that's right, he has missed a few points. He's left a few points on the paddock, but couple of really poor errors there, weren't there, and those passages of play going over the dead ball line when you should really touch down. That's a really poor error. That's something that you don't want to do at home. Don't do that at home, kids. If you're looking to play rugby, don't do that run over the dead ball line when you should score a try. And then Heavy's kicking the ball out on the full from a dropout. Another poor mistake.
Here's Dulanjan fends off one, and good tackle coming in by Havelock. It's once again Jason Melder. Dulanjan have scored 11 tries in this season so far. And lovely up and under this time. Too much collision in the air. But knock on by Chamika Kusal.
It looks like Navy are starting to play a little bit more of a pattern game. Dulanjan, Weerasinghe is really coming into the game, isn't he? Every time he carries the ball, he's making great meters. There was a great catch there from the kickoff. Sidestepped one player, went straight into contact and didn't go backwards. He went over the advantage line and just makes it so much easier to clean out when your player goes over and falls past the tackler. Easier to clean out, easier ball for the halfback. Much better for the team, obviously.
So Situm Pires comes in and Chanel Dias goes out, and also join the next fitness revolution on the popper.com/health. Workout right with fit.lk, where Isuru and Natasha will guide you through the right form and technique in workouts. You can share your fitness transformations with our official hashtag Stay Fit Nation. We're still in the 57th minute. There's plenty of time remaining to play. Anything could happen. Just a point different. Navy 18 and Havelock 17. Laga.
Yeah, those points could be crucial from Dillina's put, but all Navy's got to do now is play at the right side of the field. And I think that would be the instruction from the bench. And that was every time that skipper gets the ball, Vichesinger for Navy, he's dynamic, you know, it's hard to stop him. Only way you can stop him is chop his legs off, go tackle a bit lower. But he's carrying quite effectively for Navy, but we'll need to play to perfection in this last 23 minutes of this game for them to get away with this one in their home turf.
And here we go, another scrum, also another change in the front row for Navy Sports Club. Nivanka Prasad sending out to Chandimal to Madhuranga. Another pick and run by Nivanka Prasad, the man who could not score inside the try line. Quite unfortunate, but here's Navy. Havelock's trying to counter rock. Still the position with Navy. Too many numbers committing in that rock and breakdown. Here's Chandimal sending it to Lahiru Herath. He's been a real star for Navy Sports Club. Brilliant run by Lahiru Herath. And Chandimal to Roshan Ranasinghe. Navy. Rishi Dharmapala. Once again to Chandimal to Heshan Maduranga this time. Nivanka Prasad. Hiranta Pereira. Putting him down. So much space in the line. Just a matter of running the angles. Kasun De Silva now. Dharmapala. Another flat line by Navy. And still have the position. And Chandimal trying to find some space. Adisha Veerathunga. Adisha steps, breakthrough, twist and turns, comes in. Havelock's under pressure. Navy marching forward now, trying to walk into the shorter side. Chandimal switching directions. Good tackle by Surya Arachi now. Referee says play on, ball comes loose now. Another good tackle. Holding on, says the referee. We might see a card coming out, not sure. It was Hiranta Pereira who made that tackle.
So they really stretched the Havelock's defence there from going from one side to the other, and there are holes opening up in the middle of the park. It was just unfortunate there, right at the end, the ball broke down from the nine going to the first receiver. If they'd gone to hand and they'd run straight and used their hands, they had the numbers on the outside, they had a seven or eight on four. Out on the side closest to us, viewer, closest to the commentary box, but they just need to keep attacking and holding on to the ball. Great play there on the other side by the winger when he cut inside and he just twisting and turning like a twisty-turny thing, wasn't he, Sabir?
Indeed, Adisha was excellent, but this is not what Havelock's wanted. Niroshan Fernando, the experience is going into the sin bin, but quite unfortunate.
Yeah, well, this we spoke about, about who's going to last. Condition-wise, you know, with the heat out there, and it looks like Navy are picking the right time. You know, that attack there was quite ferocious from all parts of the field, and Havelock's were finding hard just to hold them in the middle. You know, some power play there, and that was good to see the big boys just taking it straight up the middle. Be interesting what to see. What were they going to do with this penalty? As Sabia mentioned, with Niroshan being put on the simbin for. Repeated offside, being in an offside spot, that sort of took away the chance for Navy to get that five, even 7 points. As we see, Dylan are now lining up for the 3 points, so they want to win.
Well, it's a pin drop silence by Navy spectators, and they're all expecting this kick to go through the post, and Navy. Oh dear! I thought for an instant he was put that kick out of the uprights, but somehow he managed to pull it through. That's good stuff by Dilna Veerasinghe. Navy 21, Havelock 17.
Well, I think that was the right decision. I think that was the right decision to go for the points because I think Navy are going to be back down this end very shortly as well. So, you know, you just take the points, come back, let's have another attack, and just come back. They've got to really put the heat on now. They've got 10 minutes with a one-man advantage. Just run everything. I believe they're starting to run Havelock's off their feet. The big men are struggling to get around the park. You can see Havelock's are slowing the game down. They're looking for the ball. They're all slowing the game down completely. Charlie Brown there just touching his watch, saying time off. He's saying time on again now. So that'll be the game plan for Havelock's. Slow the game down, wait till they get a full complement of players, and then come back.
Here we go with the restart now. Navy breaks through. Good stuff by Supan Dilshan. That was a bit high.
How's the catch on that restart? L.A. Hooper just reached up. That's beautiful. As we see Janaga there, just playing it safe. Oh, he's kept his hand on the ball. And the man in front, now the mistakes. Errors are creeping into Havelock's game there. Man in front there, and Janaga just tuck his hand out. And that was a good 50-meter clearance from near the Navy fly half. But that was impressive, that kickoff take.
Yeah, that was. It was, look, like a little bit Aussie rules. And then the referee's just checking with the linesman to see if that player was out when he hit the ball. It was out. So that comes back, and it's now heavy throw-in because the player was out when he touched the ball. So that means he was in an out position, and the kick was by Navy.
We're into the last quarter of this game. It's all happening here, 21 points to 17, and Navy has a numerical advantage now. Not sure what is this.
Yeah, the crowd is yelling at the linesman. I'm not too sure what the linesman is. I think the ball was already out when Jamika touched it. So there's a bit of tussle there. Who gets the throw in? As we see Prasad being brought in by coach Ronnie for Havelocks. And Udara is on for Janik Jazuria.
Well, Prasad Madhusankar with his first throw of the game. Nicely taken by Sitham Piris. Pick and drive once again. Prasad Madhusankar, of course, scored the highest tries last season in the Dialogue Rugby League. And that's a lovely kick into space. Good chase coming in as well. Good pressure by Chamika Kusal. Supun Dilshan trying to rescue the Navy team, but he should have given. Havelocks putting a lot of pressure now, winning a penalty. Off it, says the referee.
So the Navy player was coming back with and collected the ball. He had an opportunity to pass there, but he just turned around and instead he collected the Havelocks player. And that's I'm surprised they took the quick tap because they've got one man short.
It would certainly be a punish for them here if they get some points with Van der Rosen on the bin. As we see them rumbling their way up, and that was a quick sneak through there by Duswanter, and Suryarachi has come to Hiranta for some answers, and a long pass out to Nizon, and just in and out, and he's gone. And oh, over he goes, Nizon. That was superb stuff.
Absolutely brilliant stuff by Nishan Pereira. We saw him scoring against Kandy last week, beating four defenders, but this time again another individual brilliance. Just a sidestep to Thilila Weerasinghe, and there he goes in the far corner. Brilliant stuff by Nishan Pereira.
It was brilliant stuff. It was a great little in and away. He sort of caught the ball almost standing still. His hips and shoulders said he was going inside, but his body went outside, and that was enough to stop the defender. Just stood the defender up, and he had enough pace and enough space to get around on the outside. But great play there by Havelocks, and maybe the game's turned back in their favour. 14 men, they held on to the ball. They got that lucky break where it looked like they'd knocked the ball forward, and there was a penalty against them. Instead, it gets turned by the linesman. Okay, they come back, they get to throw into the line out, they hold on to the ball, they drive it up, they put that kick in. It's not tidied up there by Navy, and all of a sudden they're scoring in the corner.
Yeah, well, you've got to say that as Hiranta lines up this conversion from just a bit away from the sideline, nope, just away on your right. So 22-17, the score is Havelocks leading the way in this halfway through the second half. But you got to say that this Nissan kid is growing in confidence. You know, it's just his second year in the league, in the A Division League. It's getting bitter and bitter.
Yeah, that's right. He's continuing to improve. But the coaching staff from Navy, I could see the coach up in arms there. He wouldn't be happy with that performance. They got 15 players against 14, and they let Havelocks come in and score a try. You know, he won't be happy with that at all.
Ooh. Well, Adisha Weerathunga went to get that high ball. But it's not a foul play at all. He's just going to the ball.
That's right. It was a great commitment there by both players. They both were going for the ball. He just jumped up and has jumped into the player, and he just caught him on the thigh, that's what flipped him over. And I'm not sure if he landed on his head, but it's not looking good for him. And that's great commitment there. And that's the kind of reaction you want from as a coach. You want your players to say, right, that's not good enough. Let's come back and let's do something about it.
Again, that's not a good news for Navy Sports Club. And we can see Suranga Pushpakumar also come off the bench now. And not sure who's the Havelock player is down. Looks like Sinal Dilaka, former Isipathana captain.
Well, Pushpa Kamara, who came on, he's the one his first, almost his first phase of play was when they Havelock's put that box kick in, and he was back there. That was his space. And it just went over his head. He wasn't quite tall enough to take that ball, and that's what got them into trouble.
So here's the scrum now, just outside the 22-meter. Havelock's put in. Sudham Suriarachi, number 8 breaks, Lasindu Ishan. Suri opt to kick that. Straight into Supun Dilshan. Supun steps and Supun breaks through. Brilliant skill by this man. And that's a thumping hit on Pushokumara, but it doesn't matter as Chan Dimal. Oh dear me, referee calling for a forward pass, but that's a clever piece of work by a little magician Pushpakumara, known as Pukke. But that's a forward pass and the referee has to bring back play.
Yeah, it was a bit unfortunate, but I thought the winger there for Navy on the blind side did brilliantly on that box kick by Suriarachi. Took Jamaica on, you know, took two defenders on and went through the middle. So they're a bit unlucky there, but yeah, the replays are certainly so forward.
Supun Dilshan played for Science College, played for Sri Lanka under 19. He has travelled with the National Junior Tuskers to Malaysian tour, and also in the sevens team.
Yeah, clean pair of heels there. Little step, saw the gap, set it up. Little tiny step, accelerated straight through the gap, and then a nice pass as well. But they were brought back.
Now Hiranta Pereira playing as fly half, sending it to Dixon. Dixon fend off and lovely pass to Vimukthi Rahula. Rahul opts to kick. And Dilshan, it's that man once again. This time he opts not to kick. Going into contact. Don't know whether it's the right decision, but Navy has the position inside the red zone now. Pushpakumara. Oh, Nivanka Prasad misses it and Nishan Pereira knocks it on. Referee calls for a try. I thought Nishan Pereira also made a knock on. But referee giving the try, not consulting the assistant referee. Says thank you very much.
So Navy really architects of their own demise here. They're back in that position. There was an opportunity to kick. And instead of kicking, the winger decided to take the ball into contact. And really they got turned over there. Well, they didn't get turned over, but the clearing and the exit, that they just didn't get that right. And found themselves in trouble.
Oh, they've got it all wrong, Navy, there. You know, they got a muscle man to be the first receiver inside that 22. And where was their fly half and the guys who really exit, get them out of trouble? Don't know where they were, but you know, you feel that number 8 just not managing to hold on to that ball. And he had about 4 Havelock's guys in front of him. And I thought Nissan got his hands on that ball. And the referee, of course, looked at the linesman. Nothing saying. Tried to Nissan and... Havelocks will be pretty happy where they are, you know, scoring 2 tries when they've got their fly half Niroshan on the pinch on the pin.
We were talking about Supun Dilshan. It's all about inexperience, but Hiranta Pereira made that 2 points look so easy. And also Nivanka Prasad just could not hold on to ball position. It's not what Navy wants, especially a man down in the opposite team.
Yeah, that's really disappointing for Navy. You know, what sort of reaction are they going to get here? You know, they must be really upset with themselves. Really, that was an opportunity for the halfback to put a box kick in. The pass wasn't the option. The box kick was the option.
Yeah, they've got some work to do now. We've only got 14 minutes left on the clock, Sabi. Boys, with the score now going out to 29-17, as we see... Situm Pretis there just going up for that one and demanding it and winning it back. And Rahul is on the pitch for Suriarachi. Havelocks as he puts a lovely box kick up. And Chamika gets on to Vidasinghe very early there and stopped him on his heels from not going anywhere. And they've counter-rucked that one. But just using the hands, says Charlie, Mr. Charlie there. So a bit of luck for Navy.
That's a good tackle on Wesleyite against Wesleyite. Chamik Kusal versus Dulanjan Vijayasinghe, of course, is senior. But opportunity to gain some territory for Navy. Good kick indeed.
It was a good kick there. Sabir, but what I'd like to see is that when a team's got a man up, then you just play quick ball. Tap the ball, go, let's try and stretch the numbers and try and push them on the outsides and make their team stretch right across the field.
Yeah, and interestingly, I mean, how that try, I mean, how Luke scored that last try was with only six players in the back line, they managed to get on the outside. And
Here's Chandimal, playmaker, but he decided to run alone.
And again, that ball just popped out of that ruck. Boys, Navy not holding on to the ball on the ground, not really doing enough. And Havelock's now with their tails up, in defense, getting up on their faces. And again, that ball came out again. And Buke pushing it out wide. And Salia's on the pitch for Navy and stepping it back inside. Navy having all their players on the left-hand side. And again, they've opted to go for a carry out there. They've gone to the edge again, but again, the ball pops out. So ball retention's killing Navy at the moment.
Now they just look like they're a little bit flustered, or I'm not sure. They look much more secure maybe 10, 15 minutes ago when there was 15 on 15, but all of a sudden, I'm not sure, there's been a mind snap or something. Their decision-making's not clear. They're taking the wrong options. Instead of kicking, they're holding onto the ball. They're not going into contact as hard as they can. So you'd like to think that they'll change it up and maybe try and hold onto the ball a little bit longer.
Here's the line out once again. Havelock Sithum Piris taken it nicely. Rahul Disi Lossenig to Niroshan Fernando. He's back now. Here's Noor going into contact with his first touch. We still have a lot of time remaining, almost 10 minutes remaining in our clock. That's a good run and a good offload. Not so good. Havelock's need to keep position to play more faces. Rahul Disi Lossenig, eventually he decided to go for the shorter side with taking that understanding communication with Nishan Pereira. And that's Supun Piris going into contact. Is he going to get a yellow card? Yes. In fact, that's number 18. That's Shamit Madhusanka, I beg your pardon.
Look, he mustn't have used arms or something in that contact because the ball had just left the foot as the contact was made. So I thought that was pretty unlucky. Maybe he was pulling out of the contact, but actually thought that Havelock should have moved the ball, shifted the ball by hand. They had the numbers. It was a 4-on-3. Just get the ball to the outside, and they would have been around the outside of the outside edge of Navy. But now they have another opportunity to add more points.
And Hiran Tapera scored a try in the first half.
The Recap, your daily sports update. Wherever you are, tune in to the paparay.com at 6:30 p.m. on the dot and be updated on what happened around you.
The Hero Cup second ODI between Sri Lanka and Australia. Australia leading the series 1-0. The news is that Angelo Matthews has won the toss.
The idea was right by Dushmanta, but not the execution, as he kicked that kick out on full. And Havelock, so with this line-out ball, Rahul Disi Lossenig sending it to Dushmanta. Rahul once again with an inside pass, that's sloppy. But still, somehow Havelock's march forward with position. And unfortunately, another knock-on, so time is ticking. But still, 7 minutes remaining here at Valisar Grounds.
I'll tell you what, Sabir and Lager, it's not the the most crisp game of rugby I've ever seen. There's a lot of mistakes, a lot of errors. The ball's going to the ground a lot. You saw Raoul look like he was going to go one way. Did the little George Gregan flip the ball back on the inside, but no one was running that line, and the ball bounced around. They managed to hold on to it there, but then they knocked it on again. You see a mistake like that. You see a mistake like DeLangelo kicked the ball out just before. We saw other areas earlier on. And, you know, we'd like to see a bit better, higher skill content in our games.
Yes, still Veerasinghe, a long pass by Chandimal. Veerasinghe beats two defenders and a lovely offload to Chandimal. And a good tackle by Vimukthi Rahul as well. No one at the back now.
The Recap, your daily sports update.
Just needed to be moved through the hands. They had numbers on the outside. They probably had a three-man overlap, and they just need to make sure that they run straight, use the hands, use the ball, make the ball do the work, and just get it through and get it to the outside man. And then that man is running at the edge, and then he can draw and pass the last man, and they were away down this far side here. I mean the near side.
Yeah, it's just the decision making on when to pass and when to go. So later there, just needed to shift that ball on the outside. But it's always going to be tough when you're trying to play catch-up rugby. You saw that run inside their half. They did well from that scrum with only seven men in the scrums. He's got their number eight on the simpin, or their flank on the simpin, sorry. So they ran it, did it, and they got through. But then, again, Mia went the wrong way. I thought he had gone back inside. He came back on the outside where he had some players, some support on the outside. So he managed to keep the ball in hand. But he just kept the feeling.
To Dilshan, cuts inside. He needs support. He can't be isolated. Nivanka Prasad. That's a bit.
Jeez, he's strong. He just brushed his off players from. And the referee has played advantage here for Situm, pushing the offside, lying on the fringes. Again, Navy has gone to the side. Yeah, that's a bit of better play from Navy, a bit of positive play there, knowing that the penalty was going to come. So referee Charlie has come back to the penalty. So quick tap has been taken, and he needs a bit of support there in the middle as he fights his way through. A lovely shift there, and a beautiful carry. It's gone 20 meters. And again, another quickie pick and go. Just need some numbers here. And Prasad has done well for Havelock to stay up on that one. But he's still going. Again, another quick pick and go. And they're doing well, finding some yards in the middle. Now it's the time to go. Let's see how. And he finds a space outside. And finally.
It's Supun Dilshan, that man, finally scoring a well-deserved try despite that early decision-making mistake inside the 22.
Yeah, brilliant stuff there by Navy. Their forwards are really marching their way up, finding the...
The Recap, your daily sports update. Wherever you are, tune in to the paparay.com at 6:30 p.m. on the dot and be updated on what happened around you.
There are the boss. But there, what a bizarre game. When you have 14 on 15, that seems like that's when people are able to score. Navy are coming back now with a one-man disadvantage. And what was it was all about taking the ball at the advantage line. They were pick and driving. And taking advantage of a defence that's not set, and just going straight over the advantage line. But real strength there from the Navy forwards to take the ball up over that advantage line.
Correction, that try was scored by Gayan Vikramaratne, former Isipathana player, who also played in the under-19 Sri Lanka. That's Dulanjana Vijayasinghe. And here's Chandimal. Chandimal to Nivanka Prasad. To Kasun. Navy. Still with position. They need to score one more points. And also the conversion was taken by Chanaka Chandimal, not Tilna Veerasinghe. He's out of the field. Here's Kasun De Silva. Strong run, trying to rattling through the Havelock's defense. Looks. And Senal Dilaka goes under the post. That's all for Navy, I think. Havelock's scoring that try. Defenders didn't have a
struggling to find any players that really stood out. What do you think?
I actually think Dusmanter, again, the skipper for Havelock's was outstanding. You know, the small parts of the game that he was very crucial, carrying the ball up, scrum lineouts, and he made a few tackles. He got around the park as the game grew, and some of the decisions that he made was actually right on the spot. But Navy, Navy would be very disappointed with their performance. You know, they were right in the game, right up to the end there. But as we see there, the class of Havelock's and the determination that some of those players have, and having Rahul, as we spoke about Rahul coming on to the game and then adding on to what they had. You know, the calmness he had in that last play, just dishing out the ball, and that last pass to Seneca to score the ball underneath the post. And Havelock's too good today.
When the game turned, there was a
The Recap, your daily sports update. Wherever you are, tune into the paparay.com at 6:30 p.m. on the dot and be updated on what happened around you.
The Hero Cup second ODI between Sri Lanka and Australia. Australia leading the series 1-0. The news is that Angelo Matthews has won the toss.
Hey guys, I'm Isuru, this is Natasha. We are Revolution Athletes and we are the founders of fit.lk.
So basically, we are partnering with the Papa Ray to bring you a mini series called Workout Right Fit.lk. We're going to help educate you on how to get the most out of your workouts. And not only that, we're going to motivate you through the fitness journey you're about to start.